News 10 at For Your Health Now. It is Monday, and chances are a lot of us feel like we fell off the diet and exercise wagon this weekend. Not Mike, of course, but we did. That's why every Monday we have our For Your Health fitness consultant, Dr. Mike Ormsby, to get us back on track. Thank you for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
Now, Dr. Ormsby is an assistant professor at Skidmore College in the Exercise Science Department. You also have your own fitness consulting business, written for several popular fitness magazines. Today is going to answer your questions about exercise and willpower. We have our first question. I seem to skip my workouts a lot. Is it a lack of willpower? What do you think?
Willpower. Wow. Okay. So when we think about willpower and health, they really go hand in hand, right? I mean, if we think about a daily routine that we have and you have to choose between this food and that food, that's going to be a willpower decision. If you can get off the couch and exercise or not, that's also going to be something that will come down to willpower. So does it play a role? It certainly does. And the good news is there's some things we can do to help us stay on track for a longer period of time.
Well, the willpower, we could use it up, though. I mean, if some people think that. Is it better off to do this in the morning when you still have some strength than you to do what you need to do?
That's a great question. And with all of the clients that we serve, we always recommend getting that in first thing in the morning. Doing it that way, throughout the day, you're going to have things that come up unexpectedly. And in the end, if you can avoid that and get it done first thing in the morning, you'll have a better chance of being on track. But alternatively, as we go about our day, we need to have a reason to actually be exercising, a reason to be healthy. It has to go beyond being superficial, has to go beyond planning for a wedding or a reunion, and has to mean something to you. And once we can establish that, then we can set up goals to be active, goals to be proactive with our health as well. And we can get into things like scheduling, something really easy. If you put it on your calendar, chances are you'll get it done. If it's a meeting in your day, you're not going to skip it. And so that's going to help tremendously. And also having a plan when you do go to work out. So not just going in and wandering around and seeing if you can find this machine or if that's open or whatever. It's getting a plan and going in knowing exactly what to do so you don't waste time. You don't have to spend a lot of time to do it. You just have to be efficient.
Ah, that's a great plan. I do tend to wander around. That's a great point. Can I boost my willpower to fit exercise into my schedule? I think we talked a little bit about that, but
sure. Yeah, we did cover some of that, but if we can actually plan it into our day, then we're going to have much more opportunity to be successful with fitting it in. You know, it's all about this wellness lifestyle. Do we want to have short-term health benefits, or do we want to live a lifelong, healthy, happy lifestyle? And that's what we're going for, especially with our clients. We choose not to work with individuals who want a quick fix. We try to go about the whole level, and it begins with scheduling, and it begins with making that conscious decision to make it a priority in your life.
Well, and my last one real quickly is, how can I get started? And you would say make it a priority.
Absolutely. Make it a priority. It has to be that way.
It has to be that way, and do it in the mornings if you can.
If you can, you know it's not going to be every day, but most days of the week, if you can get even just 2 days, you're going to be set. And then you can go all day knowing you already have one thing to check off the box.
All right. And I'm sure, real quickly, does it have to be a gym or can we do it at home? We can talk about that more later, but what do you think?
No, absolutely not. Gym may be helpful later on, but there are plenty of things you can do at home, and that's going to immediately start you off. It just makes, it starts with making that decision to be happy, to be healthy. What's it mean to you?
All right, great. You know, we could talk about that next week, what we can do at home. All right, we want you to be able to ask Dr. Ormsby or any of our experts anything. Email us your questions, news10@4@WTEN.com.